Alright guys, we are getting into Fallout 4. This is going to be the playthrough in which I am going to try to get every single companion to full affinity and get all of their perks. That's the complete name of the game.
War never changes.
I'm going to be touching all of the factions, and I'm going to be doing a lot of missions. This is going to be 100% complete, but I'm going to be doing a lot of stuff. I'm probably going to be having to go
serving
through
in the army.
Any building that has,
wondered,
you know,
when he'd get to go home to his wife.
Anything to hack, probably going to go
sun
in.
He'd never seen.
Anywhere, I mean, a lot
he
of
got his wish.
Picking locks.
When the U.S. ended
hitting,
World War II. By dropping atomic bombs.
The vast majority of the quests.
In Nagasaki.
I might hit every quest. It wouldn't blow my mind if I hit every non-radiant quest in this. Because it's going to be. No, I won't. But I'll hit a lot.
Something miraculous happened.
Because.
We began to use atomic.
There's just some stuff where it's just so hard to get the affinity. And I'd really not want to do too much.
People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science
fiction. Unload
fusion powered cars
stuff just to like get affinity, because like
computers.
You get affinity every time you do a mod around certain people, and that's cool, but like we don't want to be just like
the 21st century
saving loading the game just to get it a bunch. Like I'd like
people
to show
awoke from the
on camera
dream.
Most of what I'm doing. I don't want
years
there to be a bunch of stuff where I'm just like, oh, I just ground this out.
Every major resource.
There's gonna be some stuff I cut just because
the entire world on
I don't think it makes for good
peace.
It's decent memory. Videos, but if you're wanting to watch the full gameplay, like you probably don't care to watch me build out. If you're wanting to watch the story, you don't really need to watch me build a settlement. But I can put my settlement builds off to another one, so I'll get a little bit of affinity out of those, probably.
For myself?
I don't think so.
For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing. It's that war never changes.
Cool. Alright. This is such a fun game. I'm happy to have any excuse to spend more time in here. And I'm going to be talking a bunch now because the radio is going to kick in. We're gonna
war never changes.
Do
you're gonna knock him dead at the veterans hall tonight, hun.
Kind of the bare minimum to get
absolutely.
Nate set up, and we're gonna
and
do about nothing on Nora.
Hogging the mirror.
And then we're gonna play as Nora. So that'll be interesting, but okay. Face I think I like let's do that. And then well, was there one actually with the hair? I liked. We can just do that. Okay, that's perfect. And we'll just do a body
my
form.
My turn, big guy.
Oh, too late. And then we will just end here. Okay. Nope. I don't care. We're done. Yeah, we're just done. So, the whole reason for that is that until we exit that, I can't take care of this. So, actually, I'm curious. Does it let me back into here? If it does, I...
Hey, hun.
Just getting ready.
Okay. It'd be cool if this did something into the future.
Ah, good morning, Mum. Your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Oh, newspaper.
More of the same.
With the news like that.
It's a little early to be drinking.
Oh, fine. Oh, I guess you don't like the coffee.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
Sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Shaw.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
But then we're looking at a cold front coming down from Canada, making it crisp and dry for next week's Halloween festivities. Looking in on next week's forecast, we have a high of 52 on Monday. It also appear our troops stationed overseas are experiencing some unusual
weather as
well. Let's
look at mementos.
A lot of late nights. It was worth it.
It was.
Good old U.S. of A.
This door got open for some reason.
It's that salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Did you go into the bedroom? Whatever.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling!
Vault-Tec?
Vault-Tec? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, ma'am, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Then I'm glad I opened the door.
Oh, me too. You have no idea. Now, I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
The apocalypse? Well, hell, sign me up.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
All right. So I pre-designed this a bit. We're going to try to we're going to do rifles heavy in the beginning, and then we're going to shift into either melee or pistols. So I think that that's going to be, we want to at least get up to Critical Banker. So that puts that up to 7 there. And we'd like Ninja, which puts this up to 7. And then the remaining points, can go into getting us Gun Nut. And I think one extra into the charisma. Yeah, so that'll be a good build. So what we're going to really be missing out on is local leader and armor and science. So that's the big ones that people usually will have that we won't have, but we'll build up to them. It's cool.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments. How can someone so small drink so much?
But he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection we seem to be so good at.
Go ahead, honey. I'll be there in a second to help, okay?
What's keeping you?
The glove's a little big now, but Sean will grow into it.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin?
That's my boy, on his best behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
Wait,
we seem to
what?
Have lost contact with what our affiliate stations.
Explosions?
Oh no.
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania.
God.
Mom, the news.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go!
Codsworth, stay safe, honey.
And your family as well, Mom? Oh, my.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
I don't know you. We gotta say goodbye to everyone I know.
Hold on, Lieutenant. Hold on.
All registered vault participants, this way.
Oh my God. What if we can't drive fast?
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered,
vault participants, head this way.
Evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Leave the bags. Who cares?
Also note there's no root cellar over here. Hi, guys.
I can't lose these. It'll be all I have left.
Head to the gate! Vault participants, check in there!
That's absurd! I am
not on
Vault
the list.
Tech.
You don't get in.
I'm going in.
Oh God.
You can't
sir.
Stop!
Oh God.
Hey!
I'm reporting this!
No.
If
no,
you're in
no,
the program,
no.
Step forward. Otherwise, return home!
Don't let us die out here!
Excuse me.
Why?
Are you the vault program?
We need to get in.
God, we're gonna die.
We're on my list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck, sir. And God help us all.
Guards are coming. Who cares if we're in the program?
Get to the vault.
Excuse me.
Get moving.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's gonna happen to all those people outside
the
gate?
We're doing everything we can.
This way.
Now keep moving. Step on the platform! In the center!
I want to use the minigun. Alright, I'm screwing around. Let's get on.
Keep going!
Sorry.
This way!
Sorry. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm going.
Alright, that's it! Send it down!
Almost there! Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
Oh my God!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh God.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No.
We'd all be...
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone,
okay.
Just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Vault Tech is here for you.
this way,
so there's two different walk speeds while you're doing this. There's slow and fast.
This one's good.
Step over to the table, take a suit.
You'll need your suit
before we can take you further.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three.
Yep, we're coming.
Female. A little high.
See?
Okay.
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone.
Here you
our
are.
Home.
Head down
everything
the
we had.
My mother and father down in
Ma'am?
D.C. Oh, God, honey.
How
what
long do you think we'll
it?
Be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that
and the doctor,
orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through.
He walks faster than our slow and slower than our fast.
Good tip, don't you think?
The vault just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Hey.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. Just step into the chamber.
It'll be okay. Mommy's right here. See?
Who's my little guy, huh?
Hey,
I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There she is, see? Mommy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside.
Go ahead.
And put on
I
your
just want to give Sean a moment.
Okay.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, I'm going to talk over this bit. I'm sorry if you haven't seen this. If this is your first watching through, that this is unfortunate. But so I'm going to be changing my appearance as soon as I go to enter the vault. I just didn't want to do it in the beginning because there's that radio playing, and the volume settings are different than the older games, which made it easier to avoid copyright strikes. And I don't like to talk about it too much, but it's a big deal, and it sucks. And you have to worry about it. So I'm going to customize my character when we go to leave the vault. But anyway, something interesting that they do in this is you can get plastic surgery and like redo your look after, like even after you leave the vault, through certain NPCs. And I think the game is smart enough that they actually use your original build to show what you. To show your figure in the pod later in a flashback, but they don't do that. And they don't factor in any of the new stuff. They keep your original copy. So I'm curious if they're going to keep my copy that I am right now, or if they're going to keep the copy when I leave the vault. And I think it'll be what I leave the vault as. That would make the most sense to me.
Just in a game mechanic. Excuse me.
Just in a game mechanics standpoint, that's what you'd expect.
Come on. Oh, God. I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
So it really bums me out that there's nothing you can do about any of these other people. Like, I understand, okay, my husband got shot, but it'd be cool if some of these people got, like, you could help them out and you had to activate them with the world. Oh, holy crap. Is this C3? Are these numbered? There's something later I'll show you that I found that I find it confusing. But, okay, we're going to go through here, and I'll try to note it. Let's step in here. Pod occupant status. So we have Mr. Callahan in pod 3. Alright, so a little bit about this build. So I said, yeah, we're doing rifles, and we'll be very companion heavy roleplay. So we're going to be doing a lot of people pleasing. So, I mean, honestly, that's how you can just like you'd be just. Change your personality to whoever you're hanging out with. Which is a pressing prospect, but that's what we're gonna do. So, I'm gonna hit up most major factions. I'm gonna probably do a decent amount of radiant quests, because those will make certain persons pretty happy.
What the hell?
What the hell indeed. So, I've kind of mapped out the order that I want to do companions. It really matters, I mean, what quest you're doing with who and whatever. Like, you just jump in and then you want all the companions, you don't plot it out. You're going to have a real bad time, because you're going to either piss people off because you're doing stuff, or, like... Well, the people who don't like Minutemen quests are really easy to please, because they're people who like abusing drugs. So, I like this a lot. This is a bunch of, council commands. So, I get a kick out of that, they did this. So, trigger collision, trigger detection, quit, I guess, quick save, regular save, stuff like that. Oh, shoot. Recreational terminal, and we're going to eject. Sweet. And let me actually check out what this is. Oh, never mind. Don't screw around with electricity, kids. It'll get you zapped. This game does have, situations where you can get electrocuted. It's mostly the traps. I don't think there's any, like, random environmental things like this. Except this one, actually. Yeah, that can hurt you. Alright. Yeah. Okay. I shouldn't screw around with that. That'll explode.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Even if you have a weapon, always pick it up. Pick up weapons if you have space, because you'll actually get ammo out of it.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Oh, yeah. Alright. There's one of these that... Yeah. Pod C3, which was Mr. something-something, and... This references a her. So I don't know if this is supposed to refer to the sole survivor, and it depends on your gender, or if this is just completely messed up. I also don't really know if C3 is the one that was empty or not, because whatever, but yeah, this doesn't really make sense. By the way, that's the big secret everyone's looking for. Todd Howard was like, yeah, everyone didn't realize that we made glaring mistake in, like, the second terminal you read.
Terminal's gotta be somewhere.
Wouldn't that be funny if I broke it? I'd laugh for days. Cool. What does it say about the cryo lighter? Interesting. So, the Overseer was probably actually somebody, like, really invested in, like, cryogenic freezing and stuff. We're not gonna waste weapon with these guys. You really gotta try to die in Vault 111. I mean, there's just really not enough rad roaches to kill you if you're paying any sort of attention. I apologize if I try to talk over any of the the character in-game dialogue. I'm really used to doing like New Vegas, where I like to voice the lines, so I'm trying not to do that, but still get my crap in. So some good specs. Let's see how this thing runs some Red Menace. There's one of the actual games has a bunch of references to cities, so they're like now reference only locations in Fallout. It kind of pisses me off because it's like, oh well, they're like reference only locations, but they're like pre-war, so now it's like, oh yeah, we know that this city existed pre-war. Like there was any doubt that like New York City and like just like stuff like that existed, like. Yeah, there was a New York City before Fallout games. So it's really hard to like see like, oh well, like do they talk about the pit or do they talk about this? And it's like, well, oh well, they talk about New York City. And you're like, whoa, what the heck? And it's like, oh, it's yeah, it's in a Pip-Boy game. Like, oh my, great. This is a really cool ball. I think it has a decent lore and experiment. But like mechanically and layout, it's cool. Alright, so now we're going to actually get into my character build. If you're watching the Let's Play and you want to see my character build, you're going to actually have to skip over to that video. I'm just going to split it off into its own thing. I think it's independently informative of kind of just some ways to make some decent looking characters and make them interesting. But it's going to be really long, so I don't want to include it as part of the video. But here we go. That. And you know, I think that's about perfect. I did this a lot quicker than I had before, but you know, I'm happy with all that. So we'll go back here. Oh, and the body. So fairly muscular, a little more thin than large. And we'll call that good, and we'll confirm the character. And they allow us to go change the name of the special attributes, but we're happy with Summer in that regard.
And now we leave. Enjoy your return to the surface, and thank you for choosing Vault Tech.
All right, here we are outside the vault. We're gonna just grab a few things. Because now that we're out of the vault, it doesn't freak us out to see skeletons. They were scary inside, but out here they're not so bad. Oh, there's a little building down there. Just take everything. We're about to be able to drop stuff in a workshop, so it doesn't matter. And I'm trying to find... Yeah, this is what we want. Alright, so from here we will be traveling home. Is very close to where we are right now. So I decided that this character has a bit of a interest in the writings and poetry of Henry David Thoreau, being as that you get to visit his cabin on Walden Pond as part of the game. That'd be fitting to include him. And so to end this, I'm going to read some poetry at the end of each episode. I'm going to try to make it a little bit thematic. So, I think looking out here, the poem that comes to mind is Epitaph on the World. Here lies the body of the world, whose soul, alas, to hell is hurled. The golden youth long since was past, its silver manhood went as fast. An iron age drew on at last. 'Tis vain its character to tell several fates which it befell. What year it died, when 'twill arise, we only know that here it lies. Thank you for watching. This has been Fallout 4, a game that I am tremendously enjoying. I hope that this was a decent kickoff, and we will be getting into the companion shortly. We'll be exploring a lot of quests. We'll be interacting with all of the factions. I mean, we'll be doing quests for all the factions, I believe. So just building that affinity, it should get... We're gonna get deep into the game. We're gonna hit a lot of stuff and see a lot of parts of the Commonwealth. So, hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you back. Thanks for watching. Bye.